ever since it was released on September 8th, 2022. Nintendo Splatoon 3 has gotten a reputation for having one of the most precise speedruns of all time. From pixel-perfect movements and manipulating various mechanics, the speedruns are capable of growing in a few months is truly insane. But why listen to me talk about the skills when you can see for yourself? I'm Arise, and this is how Splatoon 3 was beaten in just 54 minutes and 16 seconds. Oh, and today's run is by Launcher, so be sure to check him out using the link in the description. The clock starts upon starting our descent into the crater, and we're immediately off to the races. Within the span of a few seconds, Launcher gets recruited by Cuttlefish as the new Agent 3, making his way over to the first kettle and into the level within. A hop, a skip, and a jump later, he nabs his ad fish at the end of the level, before repeating the process with the other kettles in the area. Launcher manages to save a good chunk of time in these levels, manipulating both the respawn and Nikki mechanics, but the run doesn't stop here, so neither do we. Octavio's boss fight is up next, and after a long ass cutscene, we're sent into battle. Mowing through all three phases of the fight, Launcher is finally able to enter Alterna and actually start the game. After meeting the new and improved Squid Beak Splatoon, and suffering through a literal wall of text, Launcher makes a beeline for the first kettle. One sweet sequence break later, he goes straight to the next kettle before completing it and setting up for yet another game breaker. Landing it perfectly, Launcher jumps into a pipe to finish the first site in under 10.5 minutes. Arriving on site 2, he farms some hidden items for a good few minutes before upgrading his hero gear, jumping past some FUDs, and entering the battle against Fry. Taking down all three faces of the Eel Deal in a matter of mere minutes, Launcher heads back out to collect more items before jumping into yet another pipe to finish the second site in almost exactly 6 minutes. Not much happens on site 3, but there's something here that happens to be a highlight. You see, in amongst the many glitches of this run, there are 3 do-or-die skips that can almost instantly kill a run. We'll talk about the others when they happen, but you're gonna want to see this. He might have died, but the 45 seconds gained here solidified this as the first sub-55 minute run of the category. Touching down on site 4, he's back to the never-ending grind for eggs, sardinium, and skill points, before using the intended route for once and entering the battle against Shiva. Taking down all three phases of the cold-blooded bandit in a matter of mere minutes, Launcher goes back to collect more items before jumping into yet another pipe to finish the fourth site in less than 6 minutes. Getting to site 5, Launcher uses some of his stockpiled eggs to get around some fuzz, before employing the other trick I mentioned earlier to get past some more. You see, there's a small patch of land you can spot bomb, and with a well-timed roll out of the geyser, you can survive and skip the entire area. From here, he jumps into another pipe, finishing the site in 90 seconds. Reaching the final side of the game, Launcher grinds a few rails before using the last of his eggs and entering the battle against Big Man. Taking down all three phases of the Hype Mana Storm in a matter of mere minutes, Launcher goes back to the Squid Beak Splatoon on Future Utopia Island, before clearing off the launch pad and starting the first of 4 rocket levels. Entering the first phase, he completes it with relative ease, before getting to the first intermission and getting ready to skip the next few phases. You see, riding this beam out of bounds, you can do some simple platforming, clip through this building, and arrive at the third intermission. Entering the fourth phase, he's able to climb the tower quite easily, but the next section is where things get interesting. Grabbing the Zipcaster from McCann, Launcher is able to nab the remaining eggs in the area, clip out of bounds, scale the tower, and enter the next section within a minute and a half. Finally, in the last section of the game, Launcher decides it's finally time to use the penultimate trick of the run. You've heard about tricky platforming and out-of-bound segments, but there's one thing you haven't. Menu storage. By somehow storing button inputs on the pause menu of the Big Man fight, you're able to press the usually unaccessible skip button on the second last stage and skip it altogether. Using this menu storage, Launcher enters the fight against Mr. Grizz before evolving Little Buddy and setting off into space with Octavio's Ink Vac. And after 5 minutes of vacuuming, inking, and fighting, the CEO of Bands makes an explosive fade meaning the run ends with a final time of 54 minutes and 16 seconds. As with most speedruns today, the Splatoon 3 Any% is one that requires a lot of skill. There are so many mechanics to manipulate and sequences to perfect that it's no wonder most people don't attack this category, but those that do are truly in a league of their own. If you want me to break down the speedrun of one of your favourite games, then by all means suggest them in the comments, and I'll see you guys next week. Arise out.